She came out dressed in a cute outfit, UPS brown slacks and a chocolate brown sweater, none of it frayed. Her clothes all looked brand new. She came to the driver's door, where I had the window down, and she bent over and gave me my sister kiss. She said, "Have you heard about that really bad cold that's going around?" And I said, "No, but I have now." She rolled her eyes. I told her that her outfit was really cute. She said, "Thanks, ARC, $2 for the pants and $2 for the sweater." And I told her again, "It really looks good on you. It's really cute." I told her that I couldn't stay because I wasn't supposed to be parked there, but I never said anything about being really busy. I didn't want her to think I was anything other than completely delighted to drive over with the cookies. I passed her the cookies through the open window. Then she says, "Who made the cookies, you or Phyllis?" Naturally, I was honest, and I said, "Phyllis." She laughed, like she already knew it was Phyllis who made the cookies, because I could not possibly ever make cookies. Okay, so she's partly correct, but still, if I really followed a recipe exactly, I could probably make cookies. So she says, "Well, tell Phyllis I said thank you." And I said, "What about me? Because after all, I bought the pretty holiday plastic bucket, and I drove the cookies to her work, despite how busy I was. I thought that might count for something, but apparently not." She said, "I gave you a kiss." We said goodbyes, and I drove away and thought, it's not right that Phyllis gets all the credit for everything, especially when I did offer to help, and Phyllis said no. I thought I should at least get a thank you, too, and not just a kiss.